Hey everybody, CK here, and in this video, I'm gonna share what I was rocking to the Too Faced event. This is me and Mini Me, just showing you guys some pictures. This is the makeup look I wore, and this is the outfit I wore, and the deets on everything will be in the description box. So let go. Okay, so first I'm using this Paint Pot by MAC. Y'all know it was in my favorites. I just can't get enough of it, right? It is the MAC Paint Pot in Groundworks. And now, can y'all believe that I did not use Coco Bear? Say what? I'm using Cabin Fever. It's still a Makeup Geek shadow though. Now this eyeshadow is by ColourPop and it is in the color Wilshire. It is from their Karrueche collection. I don't know if they still have it, but this is definitely a fave when I'm going to an event and I'm rocking a neutral eye. But in this video, y'all, I step up my like day look to a night look. But anyway, this is Peach Smoothie and I was like, y'all know what it is. I shouldn't even have to tell y'all because I love it. Y'all know how I feel about Peach Smoothie. But we're putting Peach Smoothie on the brow bone and then I just take my Luxie brush and I blend everything together. Now I just showed you that Milani liner so you would know what I was using because yeah, y'all, maybe I'll do a video all about my wing liner like by itself when the angles are right. But anyway, I'm using Americano by Makeup Geek to deepen up that outer V and it's kind of like a cut crease but I don't bring it all the way through. It's just something I love about doing my eyeshadow like that. It just makes my eyes pop whether I'm doing a neutral look or whether I'm doing a dramatic look, okay? So here you go. Here we go, guys. This is where I'm stepping up this look. And so I'm using this, I think it's the MAC mixing medium, and I'm putting it on my lid only where I want the shimmer to show, okay? So I'm putting that on there, and then as I put it on there, I let it sit a little bit just so it can get a little bit tacky. So I use my hand just to kind of make it dry quicker. And now I'm using a sparkler by Makeup Geek for the first time, you guys, and I love it. Now remember, you can make it as pigmented as you want, or you can make it as subtle as you want. So I really wanted a subtle shimmer. Like it was nighttime, you know, I was going to a nighttime event. So I just wanted you to be able to look at me and get a glance and be like, woo, girl, your eyes is popping. So that's what I'm doing. And the color is an Asteroid. And I really love it. Like in pictures, in person, it was bomb. So I'm putting a little liner on and now we're priming the face. And y'all know I've been getting down with IT Cosmetics for a while now and I really, really like it. And so now I am color correcting with MAC Prep and Prime in the shade Peach Luster. And I blend that out with my finger because it seems like a beauty blender tends to sheer it out a little. Now, this blender, well, we're gonna get to the blender in a minute, but somebody on here told me that I should mix these two foundations because I told y'all one of them was more red and one of them was more yellow. And they were like, why don't you just mix the two? And I'm like, aha. So that's what I'm doing. And now right here, I am using a blender. I don't know if I want to call it a beauty blender. I was like, it's weird. It's like a beauty sponge and it's by Real Technique. I think it's called Diamond. I can't remember. I'll put it in the description box though, but it was very, very interesting, you guys. Like right here, I was like, wait a minute, this is awkward, but it blended really, really well. But I totally have to get used to using a diamond shaped sponge, but I'm definitely gonna get my use out of it, okay? So now I'm using my Too Faced concealer. And if you guys have followed me for any length of time, then you know that I blend two of them together, which is dark and tan, because I want to have a high lit or a highlighted look. And dark is more like my skin tone. So I developed this little technique here and I let it sit a little bit and then I blend it out just so it can get a little tacky because it's very hydrating and it promotes creasing if I don't let it get a little tacky. So when I was blending it out with the sponge, that point right there, it was getting me right. So I just needed to be a little bit thicker at the end, but other than that, it got me right. And now I'm using the RCMA powder. I said it wrong in my last video, but y'all see the difference? Yes. Yes, hunty. I really like this powder. As a matter of fact, if you want to know more about this powder, I have a video that I did all about the powder, like yay or nay, is it worth the hype? So check that video out. I will link it in the top right, all right? And now I am contouring my nose. I also have a video on how I highlight and contour and why I do it the way I do it. So I will link that video as well. But listen, that diamond sponge on my nose, it got me right. It was like the perfect size. It fit right there. Now you guys, we're running into a dilemma, okay? My BH Cosmetics powder is about to hit pan. What? And I do not have a backup. I need a backup. Houston, we need a backup. Anyway, I get a lot of questions on this brush. This is the Morphe E1 brush, okay? It's always in the description box for you guys to click on for your convenience, all right? So I'm setting that, and this is a Becca powder in the color Dark Golden. I have been loving using it as a contour shade. It has been getting me all the way right. And now I'm using a MAC blush. This is in the shade Raisin. This is an oldie but goodie. I may give you guys a video on some of my favorite blushes for my skin tone. Just let me know if you want that. And this right here, this is one of the new Makeup Geek highlighters, which I have a video on as well. But you guys, I was a little scared to use this color Electrify because it's a duochrome and it's kind of light. But girl, it is all good up in here. You hear me? Like, it got, I like this, like this one. And there's another color I love, Ablaze. That's it. I love it. But here is the final look, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all of your support. Oh, and the lippy, that will be in the description box as well, okay? Now, if this was an everyday look, I would totally rock my ColourPop WeHo, but since it's not, I had to get like vampy on you, all right? So check out this video up here. Let me know what you think, and I love you guys. Have an awesome, blessed day, and I will see you sooner than you think. Bye.